Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 7 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Make it a great day, a great week, and a great month. September 2nd. Watch out, baby. Holy cow. Create the perfect relationship between you and your body. Treat your body with all love, honor, gratitude, and respect. When you make it a goal to adore your body and accept yourself completely, you are learning to have the perfect relationship with anyone else you are with. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 89. NASDAQ is up 7. S&P's up 8. Gold contract down $4.60, trading at $1,811.40. Silver up down 29 cents, $23.93 an ounce. Light sweet crude up $1.32, $69.90 a barrel. Notes and bonds. The 10-year note up 2 ticks, trading 133.16. The 30-year is up 6 at 163.14. And we have the 10-year right now, folks, yielding 1.29. And King Dollar. King Dollar down 218 ticks. 92.231, Euro 118, Yen 109.98, and the British Pound at 138 to 1 U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? Well, you got a higher high. We got a contraction of volume, bottom line. We'll see where this shakes out. The contraction of volume is a monster today, too, by the way, folks, okay? So last high that we hit out here, you had 48 million, which is light volume. We're not even going to do that today, and we're going to take it out. So the real question is going to be inside of the SPY. Yesterday, we failed on volume and price on the SPY. Today, it looks like we're going to do the same thing because 453.07 is the number that we have to close above. We got above that, which is 454.05. We're going to have lighter volume. And that's what we call failure on price and failure on volume. And what that is, folks, is this is it. You get over the highs, you close under the highs, you can't hold price, and you have lighter volume. Inside the NDX 100, let's take a look at the NDX 100. What happened with the NDX yesterday was that we failed on price, but not volume. What we have out here today, bottom line, is that we're at 19 million, and it looks like we are going to fail on price. We're going to fail on price. We still might get the volume. If you get, right now, you're at 19 million. If you get 27 million, that'll be a failure. That would be just a failure on price. If we get less than 27.2 million, that's a failure on price as well as volume. Gold. Gold contract is building cause for higher price. We're in an ABC structure on the way up. Right now, gold is backing down $4.60. No big deal. You got 108,000 contracts. Gold is in a confirmed ABC structure up with a price projection of $18.94.60. Oil, you're gonna love this, man. I'm telling you, inflation's here, folks, okay? So, oil contract here, we took out the B point. Let's pull this up. Let's get this in there so you can see how this baby is. Okay, so what you have is this. Swing point from Monday was $69.64. And we had 361,000 contracts traded. Well, we're already at 374,000 contracts traded. So you get an ABC structure on the way up. Pretty cool, too. I mean, this is a big one. 69.64 is your B point, and 61.74. So we're talking, what, eight bucks, approximately $8. 67.12 is the C point. So that gives you, what, 73.12, and the high out there is 74.77. That's telling me it's going to go right for the high. That's how this baby shakes out. Notes and bonds. Now, this is the ever-ready bunny, man. This is something else. And we'll see how this baby shakes out tomorrow. But the bottom line is that you get a sideways move out here today. You don't have a lot of volume. You only get 771,000, so it's not telling us much right now in the note and bond market. It is holding price. King Dollar. King Dollar is not holding price, okay? King Dollar broke its uptrend. With the uptrend that we broke it with conviction, finally. Bottom line is that what you have with King Dollar is that King Dollar right now is trading down 220. You're at 92, 230. Your first swing point that it's going to go into is the 92, 174. Okay, so that is, what do we got? Well, that's almost a whole, that's a penny, plus 100 ticks. Every 100 ticks is a penny on the dollar. That's how this works, folks. Bottom line, my take, Kengdahl is going down to the end of the lower end of the consolidation, which is that 89,535 number. That's how that baby shuts up. GDX, let's go take a look at the GDX out here inside the gold market. GDX backing down with light volume. Nice setup. Only you're down 3 pennies. You got 11 million shares traded. You're going against 43 million. That's what you like to see, folks, if you're looking for higher price. We go take a look at inside the NDX 100, the strength versus the weakness. Strength out here, Match.com is up 6%. You got Walgreens Boots up 2.4. Mercado Libre is up 2.3. And you got Dollar Tree up 2.3. Taken away from it. Autodesk down 5.7%. Pinduoduo is up 3.9%. You got O'Reilly Automotive down 2.9%. That's very unusual. Let me go over to here. Good old O'Reilly. This thing's been going up forever. Okay, so let's see. We got the low for the year is 424. The high is 621. And what is going on with this? Let's see. I'm not quite sure. They're selling it off a bit today. They're selling it off a real bit today. Oh, look at this. Okay, so O'Reilly Automotive, man, you're at 575. This wants to go to 560. 560, the last time we had any volume on the way up. This is a break, and this is a break with volume. And if you want to see, folks, how these high volume lows are high volume highs, it works the same way. When they stick out like a sore thumb, just pay attention to them. I mean, this thing was sticking out. It had a high volume low that was generated at 579. That was generated on the 29th of July. It gets higher, and guess what? The bottom line is that this baby, oh, this is cool too. So not only that, now I talk about markets being subtle, and I think they give you a lot more information when they are. Look at this right here. Someone unloaded this 2 days ago. You can see you're going lower. Very small price spread, but look at that expansion of volume. Bottom line, you get the expansion of volume. Someone is unloading this baby, and this thing wants to go lower. Which, let me tell you something, man. We're going to be in a correction. What you have is that O'Reilly Automotive, folks, okay, always seems to be a strong stock. Dow Industrials right now up 88. NASDAQ is up 7. S&P is up 7.5. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.